What's up, guys? How's it going? Arnold here. Welcome back, and this video is going to be one for the books. This is a video that I am so thankful that I can actually say that I'm making this video and these events are actually happening. I am upgrading, I am improving, videos will be coming out a lot better. I have so much in the works and so much planned out, and I am incredibly grateful and thankful and blessed to have every single one of you guys support what I've been doing, for how long I've been doing it, and enjoying it every step of the way. For the past 4 months now, I have been grinding. I've been working on videos, I've been working on streams, I've been working on content that I'm looking into doing in the future. I'm getting back to a lot of videos here and there, but to give you guys a history of the channel and the history of, you know, my growth since I started YouTube. So first and foremost, I started YouTube almost 4 years ago. I started my YouTube channel June 30th, 2013. And since the start of YouTube, my channel has gone through a drastic metamorphosis over the last 4 years. I remember when I first started my channel, I was using nothing but a Roxio game capture card and, you know, a mic for commentary. Since then, I've upgraded. When I started anime, I was only doing screenshots because I didn't have a webcam that I wanted to use. Down the line from there, I actually discovered that my laptop had a webcam, and I was doing very low quality reviews and live stream discussions and stuff like that when it came to anime. And when it came to the video quality of my videos, I found content in the current webcam that I use, the Logitech C920 that I got off Amazon a couple of years ago, and that has been the staple of all of my videos since then, and something that I was really glad to kind of take that next level. And I can honestly admit that the audio quality of my videos has been something that has fluctuated during these last 3.5 years, primarily with me having the over-the-ear Turtle Beach headset. And then I ended up getting the lapel mic that some people liked and some people didn't, just because the frequency level of my reaction videos wasn't able to be contained within that lapel. And I'm currently satisfied with the current microphone setup that I have of my Blue Yeti microphone. So I'm actually really proud of the fact that my channel has gone through such a metamorphosis and growth. So in the last 4 months, I've been doing a lot of research and saving a lot of money and looking into kind of like the two core aspects of what I want my PC to prioritize in. And the two factors that I ended up coming out with was high processing power and RAM, primarily for like the video production side of things. My videos can render a lot faster, I can edit and actually do multitasking factors to where I'm not doing one thing at a time like I have been on this laptop. And the second factor was also high processing power and, you know, graphical leaps, just because I'm going to be doing a lot of gaming content either on YouTube or on Twitch and just in general, and I want to be able to have like a really good experience when I play something like League of Legends or Overwatch, or like play a game with you guys online. And I've taken a lot of recommendations from my personal friends as well as people online. My friend Kyle is actually going to be building my computer, because as much as I know how to use a computer, I don't know a computer. I don't know the internal workings. I don't really understand like the innards and kind of like the tech savviness of what goes into a computer, how does it go into a computer. So while I'm buying all the expensive parts, my friend Kyle is very reliable. He's built his PC, he's built my roommate's PC, and I have complete faith that he's going to be able to do the same thing for mine. And between now and the final product that you guys will see at the end, I'm just going to go over a rundown of showing you guys the parts that I got. I will leave a link in the description to my PC part pick if you guys want to check it out yourselves, but I'm basically going to show the parts to you guys and give you like a dummy version of what I think each part goes into and how it's going to help the channel, how it's going to help my content. And ultimately, at the end of the day, I want you guys to know that I'm really thankful and grateful because you guys allowed me to do this. You guys allowed me to improve my content. You guys have allowed me to take my channel to the next level. And without you guys, none of this would have been possible, you know? But right now, I'm going to show you guys the components of the PC. Like I said, the link in the description to my PC part pick will be there if you guys want to check it out on your end. But thank you guys so much. You guys will be able to see the final product of the PC and my new room setup. I'm actually changing my room around, and I'll also switch to my vlogging camera to give you guys a quick pre and post of what my room looks like before and what it'll look like afterwards. If it's what I'm envisioning it to look like at the very end, I'm gonna be so stoked, and I really hope you guys enjoy it. So like I said before, I have no insight in terms of PCs. I have no idea what I'm talking about when it comes to computers, so be sure to tell me how much of an idiot I am in the comments. But starting off, I got the Intel iCore processor. This is the 6700K desktop processor, and I think what this does is this allows like my computer to process a lot of things really quickly. It says here that it's 4 cores, 8-way multitasking processing, And this is kind of what I'm going to need to have my computer get a lot of stuff done at once and be able to manage a bunch of different things. At least that's what I think. Next up, I got a Corsair Liquid CPU cooler, which this is, I think, what cools down that i7. And I'm assuming it's just so it doesn't overheat or anything. Sorry, I haven't taken it out like it's plastic, so it does have a glare on it. But I assume this is just something that keeps my computer really cool down. Next up, I got a DDR4 gigabyte motherboard with a bunch of numbers and letters. I think this is what, like, you use to hook everything up, like the internal stuff and the external stuff. And this is kind of like your overall hub for everything that's going to go into, like, processing and whatnot. Like I said, I have no idea what I'm talking about. This is what has the USBs. This is what holds the processor. It has charging docks and all that other stuff. So this is kind of like the hub of what everything goes into. Next up is the RAM here. I got the G-Skill Ripjaw model. 2 16 gigabyte like sticks. I guess this is like the RAM. I think RAM stands for, I don't know what it stands for, but I think it's considered like the short-term memory of your computer, or it's the long-term memory, and then the hard drive. It's one and the other, like hard drive and RAM. One of them is short-term, one of them is long-term. But I know I'm gonna need a lot of RAM for like video editing and stuff like that. I don't know if 32 is kind of over the top, but just to better be safe than sorry, I decided to go with this. And then for the overall storage, I actually got two storage sets. Here I have an SSD, and this holds, I think, 250 gigabytes. So I got that from Samsung. And then I have this one that's actually in a case. This is a Seagate Barracuda 2 terabytes, 2.5 terabytes. And I was told to put kind of like the things that really don't matter, like my games or any optional stuff on the SSD, and to put all of my important things like my video files and stuff like that, stuff that I kind of want to make sure is actually on here, to put it on the actual hard drive. I'm probably going to have like a backup file as well. I might get another one in the near future, a backup file just in case something goes wrong. If my, you know, if my hard drive gets fried or if I lose any files, I always want to have a backup. So the next thing I have right here, this is like a little envelope thing. I'm not going to show you the front because it has like a bunch of numbers and stuff, but essentially this is my operating system, and this is going to be Windows 10. I've been using Windows 8 literally for the past 8 years since I got my laptop, and I know a lot of people prefer Windows 10 over Windows 8, and I know some people say that it's kind of good, but Windows 7 is the best. I opted to go for Windows 10 because Windows 7 is super expensive, number one, and number two, I am going to be doing like a merging of console gaming, like mainly on like from Microsoft's end, it's going to be like Xbox games. And Microsoft has like this thing where you can kind of play your games either on your console or on your PC. And since I'm going to be vying for more of a console experience, I can play my games either on my Xbox One or my PC, and I can play with two different communities of people. So that'll be a better entry for people who either have a PC or have a console that want to play games with me, or if I do game nights on my streams and stuff like that. So that's one of the main reasons why I decided to go with Windows 10. The next big thing here, and this is probably what a lot of people are wondering, my graphics card, and this is basically what makes my games look pretty. I decided to go for a GeForce GTX 1070. I know that I wanted to get the NVIDIA 1080, but it was just way too expensive, and I feel like I'm kind of going overkill when it comes to graphics. I don't want to keep showing this because it does have, it still has the wrapping on it, so there's like a gloss or whatever. But this is essentially my graphics card. This is what's going to make all of my games look really pretty and run really well. And be able to play like on ultra settings. I don't know about the whole overclocked. I don't know what that means. I think that means like you can push your settings to beyond what they are, but it's gonna like super clock basically. It's gonna overclock your hardware. It's gonna make your things run a lot faster. So essentially this is gonna make my games look a lot prettier. I play League of Legends. I've been playing League for the past 3 or 4 years or so, and ever since I've been playing League, I've been playing on the lowest settings possible, because that's the only way that the game will run on my laptop. So I'm actually really happy to be playing like League of Legends and Overwatch on the highest settings possible. I know people like PC Master Race and stuff like that, and I know my games are gonna look a million times better on the computer than on a console. So I kind of wanted to go big as much as I could. Like I said, I wanted to get the 1080, but it kind of was gonna break the bank at that point. But I'm kind of happy with getting this. This is the same one my roommate has. And I look forward to what my games and, you know, my overall features are going to look like once this is put in. And then we got my EVGA Supernova Gold Power Supply. And this is basically the power of everything. Hopefully nothing happens to where, like, my freaking power goes out or something that kind of fries this. Because if so, I'm kind of fucked. And I'm really, really scared about, like, hoping that nothing like that ends up happening. But I ended up going with this. I'm pretty sure this is what its only purpose is, as a power supply. It's really quiet, so it has like a really quiet fan, so it's a fully modular design. So it's going to give me the biggest bang in terms of powering everything, and it's not going to be super over the top loud. Like, some of my consoles have been really loud, and for the most part, I don't think I've ever seen like or heard a PC that's really, really loud. So I'm glad I ended up going with something like this. This is like a really good quality when I picked it up. This is a little minor thing, but I also got a disc drive. Obviously, I'm going to need this when I play like certain games and stuff like that. This is going to play like CDs and DVDs. It doesn't play Blu-ray, but I don't know, or at least I hope I don't have to worry about any PC games being Blu-ray disc based. I do have an Xbox One and a PS4, so like if I get any Blu-ray discs that I want to play or listen to or whatever, I can do that on those and just play it through my console. But I decided to go for this for like any music that I want to listen to or any like movies that I want to watch on my computer, so I don't think that's too much of an issue. And obviously the games that I'm going to be getting, if any of them are disc based, then they're going to be played on here as well. And then when it comes to monitors, I got this bad boy. I actually got two of them. I'm going to be dual monitoring. So I have two LED 27-inch monitors by Acer. So that's kind of like the dream setup that I've wanted for a really long time, is having dual monitors. I have an L-shaped desk. You guys are going to see it once everything's put together, but I opted to go for this. It's 60 hertz, so it's not like the most high tier. I know like 144 hertz is what a lot of pro players and competitive players play. But this is my first PC. I know I can always upgrade in the future, which is what I'm planning on doing. I'll probably keep one of these 60 hertz for like a screen that I'll watch like minor things, or like whenever I stream, this will be the screen that I use to monitor the chat and like read people's comments and stuff like that. And then the 144 hertz is obviously going to be the one that I'm going to be playing games on. So getting into the peripherals, the one thing that I will say that I didn't worry about was the mouse and keyboard. Initially, I'm trying to get used to a new way of using my tech, since using my keyboard and mouse on my laptop has been something of a habit that I've been using. I know how to use the keyboard on the laptop. I know how to use the mouse pad really well, and I'm going to be going back to a separate keyboard and a separate mouse. Currently, I have a wireless Logitech mouse, so I'm going to be kind of using this for right now. I like it as is, and you know, it gets the job done, and I can play my games on it really well. And I just got back from Staples. I got like a pretty basic keyboard. Like I said, nothing that I'm really looking into in terms of gaming. I'm honestly prioritizing right now just setting up my PC and being able to make better videos more frequently, and you know, be able to do multiple things and kind of taking the next major step in hardware, so I'm not kind of hindered by what I've been dealing with for the past 3.5 years or so. And similar to my PC as a whole, I know that now that I have everything, I can always upgrade down the road. I can upgrade my graphics card, I can upgrade my hard drive, I can upgrade my mouse and my keyboard, but for right now, as a first PC, I deserve to have a mixture of good things and basic things, and that's why I'm not really kind of over the top crazy of like getting something like a mechanical Black Widow, you know, keyboard, and then like a Razer Naga mouse. Like, I'm not trying to be MLG pro status, I'm honestly just trying to upgrade my content overall, so it's something that I'm comfortable with, that I don't have to worry about for several years. So that is all the tech that I have right now. The box is on the side and it's really fucking huge, but I got a Fractal Design refined R4 black case that everything's gonna go in. I have my black desk here that I'm gonna be switching around. My setup is basically gonna be flipped, so what I'm dealing with right here in front of me, all of this is gonna be gone. The setup that's over here is gonna be coming over here, and my setup is gonna be going in the corner where you guys are gonna still see that setup, but my room's basically gonna be flipped, so you're not gonna see my bed, you're not gonna see my window or anything like that. And before I switch over, the last thing that I'm gonna show you guys, which some of you guys probably won't be expecting, I actually picked up some wall foam. So this is kind of like the stuff that you put on your walls, like anything that you'll see in like a recording booth or something like that. Essentially, this is going to be going on my walls to kind of muffle out any other sounds, just to kind of have a more of a professional sound whenever I record things. And so like my room isn't kind of loud and crazy when I'm either doing a reaction or I'm playing a stream with people and my roommate's room's right next to me, I don't want to bother him. So these will be actually padded on the back corner of the wall alongside my setup. So I thought that was kind of like an extra thing to go based off of, just to make the room look a lot more professional and to just have the overall sound quality a lot better. Like I already mentioned, I have the Logitech mic, I have the Blue Yeti microphone stand set up as well, and all of these improvements will be coming together tomorrow. My friend Kyle is going to be coming over in the morning and putting the PC together for me, so he is a godsend in helping me do that, because I don't fucking know how to put a PC together. And in the meantime, I'm going to be dismantling and changing my room around. So simultaneously, my room is going to be having a makeover, my PC setup is going to be put together, and ultimately you guys are going to be getting a new setup for the rest of the videos from here on out. This is actually the last video that I'm going to be recording in this setup as well. So I really hope you guys look forward to it. And like I always mention to you guys, thank you so much for enjoying the videos. Without you guys, like literally without you guys, I'm nothing. I'm nobody. And you know, the parts for the PC that you guys helped me with, and the fact that you guys have allowed to support and help me grow and help my, you know, my channel flourish and my subscriber count grow and help me move out and everything else in between, you know, getting me to go through all of these experiences, going to RTX, meeting fans and everything like that. I'll never forget it, you know, and I can honestly say you guys got this for me, you know. You guys' support is what funded all of this, and I'm really grateful and thankful that you guys have decided to help me out so much. The laptop, I will definitely be showing off the laptop once the PC is set up, like kind of like big brother, little brother thing, because this computer definitely needs like, it needs like its own tribute video at this point for how much it's gotten me through. But I hope you guys enjoy the rest of the video. I'm gonna be jump cutting. Kyle's gonna be coming over tomorrow. My room's gonna be getting changed up, and you guys will see the final product really soon. All right, guys, so before I get into the final rundown of the overall metamorphosis of my new setup, I wanted to give you guys a quick pre and post look of my room, just based on the fact that I think the change is going to be somewhat drastic. It might not, and I want you guys to use my bed as a point of reference for what's going to be switching around and changing in the room. I've done a room tour of my room when I first moved into my apartment with my roommate, so if you haven't seen it, it is on my channel, but I guess you guys will also be getting a full rundown of what my room looks like now. And basically getting a last glimpse of it before the room swap happens. So before anything, I just want to show you guys really quick. This is the computer case that I was talking about that's going to be assembled and placed with all of my computer stuff in it. It is a Fractal Design Define R4 computer case. Holds everything pretty snug, pretty tight. Has a lot of USB ports as well. It's just something I'm going to be using a lot. And this was just a really good model from what a lot of people told me. And then this is my computer desk that I'm going to be using. This is a black glass L-shaped desk that I got off of Target. I think I got this before the holidays, and I was just holding tight and sitting with it until I was going to get a PC to put it together. So I've actually had this for quite a bit. And L-shaped desks are really great for the overall like style of how they look. And, you know, if you have dual monitors, it comes out really well. So this is going to be put together in my room by the end of the night. And just giving a full run of my room, like I said, using the bed as a reference for what's gonna be switching around. This is the laptop. This is the infamous laptop that I've been using for the past 8 years, the past four or so in terms of YouTube. And it has gotten me through so much. I'm currently, if you guys are wondering, I'm currently hooked up to it via HDMI. And this is one of the monitors that I got for my computer setup. I was just testing it out, and it actually turned out pretty well. I like the design of how it looks overall. Obviously, it's gonna look a lot better once it's standalone. It's just hooked up via HDMI right now. But this is the laptop that's gotten me through thick and thin, and I'm really looking forward to once my computer is all set up, this thing can take a rest. This is my hub. This is my station. This is where I play my video games. This is where I edit my videos. This is where I do my live streams and everything. And as you guys can tell, I got a newest addition. I got the Blue Yeti mic arm stand set up here. I have my two lamps over here for the lighting. I have my consoles underneath, my PS4 and my Xbox One. The corner over there has all of my console games, like my PS4 and Xbox One games. The corner right there, that is the latest haul that I got from my P.O. box that I'm gonna be doing my P.O. box unboxing. Once my setup is all put together, I have my case of water over there. Going through over here, this is all the parts for my PC that I just ran down with you guys. I have the two monitors, my storage units, my disk drive, my processor, graphics card, motherboard, power supply, cooling unit, my RAM, my operating service, my keyboard, which is also over here if you guys didn't check that out. This is the keyboard that I recently got, and that's the mouse that I've always had. And then this is the foam unit that I'm gonna put up against the wall to support the audio for my computer setup. And then of course, this is the backdrop that you guys see in all of the videos. This is all my merchandise, all of my figures, my posters, things like that, my keyblade, my plushies, all that jazz. You guys might see a few different things that are here right now that aren't in previous videos, and that is because primarily I'm talking about the Team Crime figures that I have assembled and set up here, and then the Ruby Tower 2.0 right here with Mercury, Emerald, and Torchwick cinders at the very top of the original Ruby Tower. And you guys will be seeing that unboxing coming very soon. I want you guys to just take a look at this. I'm kind of overhyping it, I feel like, but ultimately the final product is gonna be really great, and I'm really looking forward to it. So like I said, my bed's gonna be a point of reference. Things are gonna be changed over here. Things are gonna be changed over here, but ultimately I hope you guys enjoy.
1 week later.
Hey guys, what's up? So we are back about a week after that last transition of me getting used to my new PC and room setup. Initially, I thought I was kind of hyping it up for no reason, but after actually having a lot of time with this new setup, I can honestly say that this was something that was desperately needed for me, for my plans and for my thoughts of what I want my channel to become, my plans of the future, and for you guys to enjoy the content and deserve a lot better quality and a lot better production of the videos. And I feel like a reveal like this is kind of over the top. It's like, you're just gonna see my room in a different light, but at the same time, I still want it to feel like special and a momentous occasion, because I also updated you guys with my my update video of the, you know, the plans and transitions and changes and additions that are gonna be coming to my channel regarding YouTube, Twitch, Patreon, Discord, new content that's gonna be coming, and then just, you know, me getting into a more productive, consistent schedule of content, whether it's live streaming or whether it's, you know, recorded videos and things like that. But ultimately, I want to thank every single one of you guys. Like I mentioned prior, the jump cut, this is a product of everyone who has helped my channel grow, from subscribing, from watching videos, for leaving comments, for leaving likes, and even those of you who will go above and beyond with, you know, sending me gifts and donations and pledging on my Patreon and just helping the channel grow ultimately. Everything that I'm about to show you guys is a product of your support over the years of continuing to enjoy my videos, to leave awesome feedback, and to help me grow into the content creator that I want to be, that I feel I can be with you guys backing me up. So thank you guys so much. And even more so, a huge thank you to my friend Kyle. Kyle came by last weekend, and he essentially is the reason my PC is working. When I pushed the power button, I didn't have to be scared that it wasn't going to turn on. He's built my roommate's PC, he's built his PC, and now he's, you know, mine's on the list for him for building mine. And I've set up all of my installations. I have a bunch of games on there, and like I said, I've had the last week to dabble, to actually play League of Legends at the top quality settings and not like the lowest resolution like I was doing on my other computer. I essentially went from an 8-year-old laptop to a current powerhouse of a PC that is able to run a lot of video games at the highest settings and to just be, you know, there for me when I need it for the videos and the editing and the rendering times, which are a lot better now, and everything else. So thank you guys so much. Thank you, Kyle. And without further ado, we're going to be checking out the new room setup, and I hope you enjoy. So let's begin. All right, guys, we're going to be checking out the new setup. 3, 2, 1, now. So I'm just going to walk straight in first. I'm going to close my door behind me. So first off, you guys obviously noticed this is where the setup originally was before the jump cut last week. So I have a bunch of my merchandise and all of my stuff over here. I have the same exact backdrop. I took an exact picture and mirrored everything completely the same way, just so my videos, my backdrop looks exactly the same and familiar for people, so people don't think like I moved or I changed rooms or something like that. Most of the stuff looks exactly the same. A few things are off here or there. Like I said, I have all of my Ruby figures, Team Ruby, Team Juniper, Team Crime, which you guys will be getting the unboxing of that probably in the next couple of days. And then I have a few other merch here. I decided to keep this nightstand just so I can have a few other things of merchandise that isn't fit on my bureau. This is the fan gift unboxing box that I'm gonna be going through and unboxing all of this stuff for all the awesome people who sent me gifts over the last couple of weeks. But I'm gonna be turning around, and this is my brand new setup, guys. This setup is too cool for me. This setup is too fucking cool for me, guys. Everything was separate and it was its own thing, and as I was putting everything together, it just meshed and it turned out way better than I thought it was, you know? That's the tower that Kyle ended up putting together. It took him about 1 hour to 2 hours to put it together for me. So again, thank you so much, Kyle. That is just the high processing modern power of what I'm gonna be dealing with from here on out, which is gonna be so fucking awesome. And also, rip to the laptop. It isn't officially dead, but I'm obviously gonna give it a long time to rest. I'm still gonna be using it like recreationally, probably gonna reset it so it's a lot better in terms of just recreational use. But this laptop has gotten me through so much. The past 8 years I've been using it, the last 4 years I've been working it to the core since I started my YouTube channel. It has gotten me through thick and thin, despite the fact of me talking so much shit about how very little it does for me in terms of my vision. But its big brother PC is gonna be able to get a lot of that done. I love mainly how like this setup and corner looks because of the soundproofing. I feel like that's what gives it its like style, you know? If that wasn't there, it would look really bland. And I decided to go again with the soundproofing because this is where I'm going to be projecting my voice and, you know, vocalizing a lot when I stream or when I do games or when I do reactions. And I want my voice to, you know, catch out as much echoing as possible, just so the audio quality is the best that it can possibly be. As you guys can see here, I have my Blue Yeti mic that's going to be picking up everything in here, which has its own filter as well, and then anything else that's caught in the back end will be caught by the soundproofing here. But like, I have the glass L desk, which is great. I have my PS4 and my Xbox One here, which I have that hooked up to the primary monitor, which is this one right here. And actually, let me pull this out so I can show you guys, like, get a little bit more in my element. So this is the setup here. I have my primary monitor. I have all of my icons for, you know, most of the stuff that I'm gonna be dealing with. This column here is mainly like my games, like League of Legends. I just got Steam, so I'm gonna be getting a lot into PC gaming. I have Ruby Groom Eclipse. I have Overwatch. I have Bioshock Remastered. And then these icons up here are mainly like my editing software and stuff that I use, like my webcam software, OBS, Sony Vegas Pro 13, Adobe Photoshop, etc., etc. And this is like a super awesome dual monitor setup. This is also a Montiome tribute that I got a little after he passed. And it was initially what I used on my laptop, and I decided to transfer it over just so I can have that familiar feel of, you know, something that I really like, which is, you know, it's very subtle, it's very simplistic, has a black background, and it's just something that shows that he's always around and I'm always thinking about him. And then this one right here is pretty cool. I found this on DeviantArt and I shared it on Twitter as well. This is kind of like a Ruby Volume 1 quotes background, which looks pretty sick. And just getting a little bit into it, just showing you guys a little bit of what it actually looks like. I have some preset stuff here. So this is like my primary monitor. This is my YouTube channel here. And this is like what you'll be able to, this is like what, mainly what I'm gonna be doing all my work on. And then this is a past broadcast for the Ruby Groom Eclipse costume DLC stream that I did. And this is typically what will happen. So this will be the screen where I'll be either recording a video, or I'll be editing a video, or rendering a video, what have you. And then this screen is where I'll have like a YouTube video or a Twitch stream on, you know, just for white noise or just something to have going on in the background, which is great. And then what's even cooler is if I minimize this, I can bring this over to this page right here. So the dual monitor is super fucking cool, and it's, again, like I said, it's a setup that I feel is too cool for me, but like I said, this is going to improve everything. It genuinely and honestly is. And to give you guys even more of a comparison, like I said, this laptop I've been using for the past 8 years. During the last 4 years, I started using it more productively for my YouTube channel. This laptop will render a 20-minute video at 720p resolution, and it will take it roughly 2 to 3 hours, sometimes 4 hours, to render a 20-minute video at 720. Come over to Big Brother PC here, which is a fucking behemoth. First off, I can play all my games on like ultra settings and all that other stuff, but that same 20-minute resolution video at 1080p will render in 20 minutes. So a 20-minute video will render in 20 minutes at the highest quality that I can dish out, you know, aside from like 4K 60 frames, which is just gonna tell you guys the scope of how much better the productiveness of my videos are gonna be coming out. Like, I'll be able to have a lot more reactions come out a lot faster, have a lot more, you know, reviews or just general videos. My streaming quality is gonna be a million times better because now I'm gonna be using OBS instead of streaming through my console. My consoles are also gonna be played off of my primary monitor, and then like this monitor I use to monitor the chat and to monitor my overall quality of that stream as it's going on in real time. I also have like my webcam up here, my phone right there. I still have Totodile from what Nicole got me from my first fan gift unboxing. But like I said, I think this setup it's too cool for me. You know what I mean? Like this is you guys helping me. This is all because of you guys. You know what I mean? And I worked really hard on the videos and the quality of the content that I really wanted to bring to you guys. And I wanted to do something that I could be proud of and something that you guys could enjoy. And at the end of the day, you guys went above and beyond, and you guys allowed for me to be able to do something like this, to go to RTX, to be able to, you know, work from home and to do something that I'm passionate and I'm dedicated about and I have a lot of knowledge and thirst for. So I genuinely thank you guys for all of that. And then, like I said, the rest of my room is a little bit of the same. Like, my bed is in the exact same spot. I got a printer over here as well. And I recently got this the other day. I still have the box for it right here, but I got a printer. It's kind of like a printer scanner because I have to do my taxes and stuff. And I've never owned a printer. I've always gone to like the library or used a friend. So I was like, fuck it, I'll buy my own. And then obviously the backdrop here is the same exact thing. I wanted to have some form of consistency despite me changing my room around and having things look a bit different. Things are gonna still look a bit different, but just by having this background here, it still has a sense of familiarity so people don't think I moved or went into a different room or something like that. You'll also probably catch my closet door and my room door in the videos. I'll have natural lighting coming out directly to the front of this part right here if I need it, so that's great too, which is why I have one lamp instead of the two now. And then this back corner here, like I said, just houses all of my other stuff. I have my February Rooster Teeth box, which you guys will be getting the unboxing of that soon. This is the recent stuff that I got from my fan gift unboxing, so I'll be doing one of those very soon as well. And then like all of my games, my Ruby soundtracks and everything else. So this is it, guys. This is the full room setup for Murder of Birds' channel of the content that I'm going to be working on. And like I mentioned before too, I updated you guys on, you know, the update video of things that I'm going to be working on from Patreon, Twitch, Discord, and YouTube, and everything else. So leave your thoughts. What do you guys feel about this entire room transition, the room setup, the PC builds, and everything else in between? Are you guys excited? Are you guys looking forward to the future? I know I am. But seriously, guys, thank you from the bottom of my heart for helping me out. I hope you enjoyed this video. And I'm going to be getting started now on some Red versus Blue because I am behind on that by a week because of this and because of something else. But I hope you guys look forward to the videos that are going to be coming out, the streams that are going to be coming out, and everything else in between. Again, leave your thoughts in the comments, and I will see you guys very, very soon. Take care.